Maxwell. Pleasure to make your acquaintance, sir.
Pleasure to be made, Sam. How are you?
Well, you know, thank your parents for that one. But I'm good. Yourself?
Quite well.
That's good. Thanks for listening, everyone.
Down tools for the day.
Yeah, look, all that aside, I think I found the most satisfying...
We were taking a bit long there.
Lead-in. Skip the foreplay. Let's get right to it. I think I found the most satisfying sound in the world.
Oh, this is controversial.
This is a huge, huge call.
Yep.
But there's a famous Star Wars one. Episode 2, Attack of
the
Clones.
Oh, okay. Yeah, I know where you're going from. Yeah, Where is that? Depth Mines?
Yeah.
Yep.
I'll insert it here. But like, if you know, you know. That shit hits.
Oh. Yeah. Great in the cinema. I have vivid memories of seeing that in the cinema.
Yeah. I had it on VHS. But I stumbled very randomly across this edit of a random anime show.
Mm.
And I've sent it to you on the grams.
On the grams.
I'd recommend opening it. There's something about this. Just play it.
Yeah.
If it... There has some random like... Ruins it. But... with deep bass headphones, better than sex.
My key takeaway here is that have you become an anime man?
No.
Like you're not like watching like Neon Genesis Evangelion or something like that?
That wasn't even English to me.
Yeah, right.
Yeah. Well, it's probably Japanese.
Maybe a bit of Dragon Ball Z.
No, I wasn't allowed to watch that growing up. I
also love how not deep cut that was. Like anyone who actually likes anime is like, are you fucking kidding me?
You've been watching anime, hey? One Piece.
Live enjoying a bit of anime. Pokemon. The animated series. Indigo League only.
Yeah, see, I didn't watch Pokemon growing up. Dragon Ball Z was too violent. Mum and Dad didn't like that.
Yeah, right. There's like one punch every four episodes.
Yeah, but every now and then there was like some real like fists inside people and like Mum and Dad just didn't like it.
Yeah.
I think it was because I played the video games a lot and you were just like 35 punch comboing people.
Yeah. Kakarot.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Great games.
Third week in a row we've done some weird voice to kick us off.
Kakarot.
Why was that like? Why was there like a temptress to that? Kakarot.
Well, some of those characters were sort of, they did sound a little bit seedy.
Oh, for sure. Master Roshi. Brother loved fucking.
Well, that's neither here nor there, Maxwell, because we are going to move on to our first segment of the podcast. And also, we should say hello to everyone that's listening.
Hello.
Hi. Thanks for coming. We still can't figure out how many of you there are, but we're...
There's between 0 and 400 of you at any given week.
Yeah.
Sometimes closer to zero.
But then all of a sudden, 400 of you come back.
Yeah, it's a bit odd.
Yeah, we can't figure you out, but we love you nonetheless. And if you're here, you're an OG, and we won't forget you. But
are you? We'll find out.
Yeah, we'll find out. If you're here 2 weeks in a row, this week on Catfished.
Yeah, if you stick around 2 weeks in a row, what's going on? Why are you here? Talk to us. Send us a message. Drop us a line in the DMs.
And just be like, this is week two of listening and I don't know what the fuck
I regret being here week two.
But let's get on to something new. Let's actually give these people listening some new songs.
Some fresh tunes, perhaps.
To wrap their listening devices around.
Their wee little noggins around, Samuel.
Let's do it. Should we go one and one?
If you want to, we can do that.
Or no, you go first.
Thanks, I was planning on it.
Yeah,
this one, my first one, is from a band we're about to see play live at Big Pineapple Festival this weekend. It's Hellcat Speed Racer.
Yep.
They have teamed up with the boys for a song called Our Friends. It's given me like big 2008 Panow Lady Hawk vibes, like on the song Embrace.
Lady Hawk, I miss that.
Person?
Just that.
I miss that. So this one, yeah, this is Our Friends from Hellcat Speed Racer. I don't know what it is about specifically about the song, but it's just fun, bright. I think good for a festival.
Mm. For some reason, I thought Hellcat Speed Racer were punk.
I mean, there's some punkness to that EDM sound.
Punk adjacent, maybe.
Punk, you know, like in the same way that like Bloody Beetroots had some punkness to them and they were EDM, you know? Yeah, that's one that I'm looking forward to seeing live. I think it'll really get the, I'm not going to say the pit, like, you know, it's, no one's going to be throwing fists, but it'll get the front row.
Couple of shapes being.
Front row's jumping.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Next one.
Hit me.
Is we had these guys on the show two weekends ago.
Friends of the show.
Friends of the show, obviously. It's the Rubens. It's the title track from their new album, Soda.
Soda.
And when I was talking with Sam and Elliot, I specifically called out this song and I was like, what's going on here? Because it's this album, there's a lot going on. Rubens kind of have a bit of a moving sound in terms of, like, if you said, like, what does a Rubens song sound like? You know, it might be a guitar driven sort of indie rock thing. It might be like almost a bit soul with some of the earlier stuff. This one, I don't know where it's coming from. It's almost got a bit of like a Kanye production to it, which I talked about in the thing. It's the song Soda from their album Soda.
Soda. That's the same people that did Hoops.
And I would really implore you, if you've sat down and heard that and go, what is this? I don't know what this is. I would implore you to go back and listen to the rest of that song because it changes a lot from there.
Yeah, right.
And it's, I really enjoy it. I think it's really cool and different from them, but it's such a, like a, wouldn't have picked it. Couldn't have, like even that beginning part, which I kind of skipped over a little bit. It's sampling literally someone's like holding like a glass of like soda water to the microphone that like, stuff like that. So
had you have played that for me and not told me it was the Rubens, I would, never in a million years would have predicted it.
Oh, 100%. Yeah. You, that's the thing. Like it's one of those ones where you could never really get that off the top of your head. It's super strange, but very cool.
Super duper cool.
Super duper cool. This last one is a song that it snuck up on me. Like in the sense that I've had it in my playlist and I've had a couple of other songs from this band in my playlist for the last couple of weeks. And I, you know, like when you've got a song in your regular playlist that you've got going around where if you looked at, like you went through the list, like you looked through the names of the songs, you'd be like, I don't know what this is.
Yeah.
But then when you hear it, you're like, no, I like this. And you refer it back to it. You're like, oh, that's that song. I've done that like 5 times where I've forgotten what this song is. And then every time I hear it, I'm like, that's a sick song. And I realize that it's like been in my playlist for like 5 weeks now. And I haven't talked about it because I just keep forgetting, I just keep overlooking it. The band is Gift. They're from Brooklyn.
That's in New York.
It is in New York, Sam. It's one of the boroughs.
New York City.
The most devious band in all of New York City. And the song, so yeah, the Gift is the band and the song is To the Stars and Back.
Yep.
Isn't that Tom DeLonge's, like...
You've lost me already.
Never mind.
No, it's not never mind. That's Kurt Cobain.
This is To the Stars and Back by Gift.
That's sick.
Very indie, shoegaze, psych kind of stuff. Those harmonies and those melodies will just get lodged in your brain for days.
I literally just looked it up and added it to my
And playlist. I'd recommend a lot of their other songs on that same album are worth a look in. All Too Fast is another one that I think is in a similar vein. So, yeah.
Yep.
Very, very love fun. That.
That's the best song you brought on in a few weeks.
Thank you.
No worries.
Glad I could bring that for you.
My turn.
Your turn, please.
Well.
Enlighten me.
I will. This one needs no introduction. You know how every now and then I go into a weird, like, alpha male TikTok edit? Song
you drop ship
world.
Yeah you like to tell us about how you've got the trillionaire grind set you know, with some videos in front of your Lamborghinis.
Yeah, it's all about drop shipping,
mate. Absolutely.
Blockchain.
It's all in the blockchain,
and I'm making like $10,437 a month. And that's such a specific number that it can't be false.
And follow me for my tips on how to do it.
Yeah, here's my 10-week program that's free until you do it for a week, and then it's $10,000.
Yeah.
Yeah. But no, part of my work is doing a lot of video editing.
Yeah.
And I was recently at an event that required a little bit of hypey music. You know, big gym boys working out, you know?
Yep.
So I was listening just through some radio on Spotify and I came across a guy called Freddie Dredd.
Freddie Dredd?
Yeah.
Okay.
And if this song doesn't make you want to run through a brick wall or make you feel like you're invincible.
Yeah.
I don't know what will.
All right. Dread me up.
It's called Devil's Work.
Let's get ready with Freddie Dreddy.
Sorry, Christians.
It's a coffee machine 2 weeks away.
This is a very hard beat that then goes into a bit of rap. But it's like, I work in finance and then I go play paddleball, not pickleball, paddleball.
I'm looking for a boy in finance, 6'5", blue eyes.
Yeah. But that to me, when you've got headphones on full blast in the gym.
Can I hit you with something controversial?
That it's shit.
No, not that it's shit. I actually quite enjoyed that. I'm probably going to download it when I edit this episode. I just don't think it would be hyped. Like it wasn't, I wasn't running through brick wall kind of music for me.
All right.
It was like slow driving windows down cruising kind of music.
There's that. Or picture yourself walking into a gym. You've just warmed up.
It's hard to do, but yep.
Or, I don't know.
I'm rolling into Sizzler. Six plates deep.
All right. You're sitting at Sizzler.
Yep.
The waiter goes, anything for you? And then you go, I'll just, actually, we'll play this out.
Bit of role play.
Yeah. Anything for you, sir? 7 cheese breads, thanks.
Somehow, it's still not selling me on it.
No.
It feels like cruising music.
Yeah, it can be cruising music. I listened to it in the gym today and I felt $1 million.
You shipped some tin?
I did.
Move some units?
I did.
Fuck yeah.
It's all about drop shipping. Like, you know, yeah. Moving some units.
Yep.
The next one, Ocean Grove are preparing for a new album, Maxwell.
I've heard this.
So it drops on the 22nd of November. It's called Odd World, and they've hinted that their old screamer may be back.
The person who does the screams.
Yeah.
Because it just kind of like having a screamer.
He's having a screamer. They sort of, they've gone in a lot of different ways.
Yep.
They've gone from heavy at the start to now like Friday night footy rock music.
Yeah.
And now they're sort of in an in-between. They've always been odd. They talk about the odd world a lot.
Friday night screamer.
Yeah.
Yep.
But this one's called Last Dance and it's a little bit melancholy, but it's got a guitar thicker than a man with 2 IQ points.
Mm.
And it's just a bit of a... You know, I just can't explain it. It's a bit, it's just melancholy.
Bit enigmatic.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'll play it for you.
Please. Here,
it's called Last Dance.
Please. Can you see the fire lighting up the way? Breathing in and out, you start to sway. Standing here, I'm calling out your name.
He's got a bit of a droney voice, but as background music, it's actually quite north.
This is, I think, maybe the second song that you've showed me over the last few weeks from this lead up to the second album, to this next album. That was the one I preferred more than the original one that you showed me, which I can't remember the name of it was. But
My Disaster, which is a bit more new metal.
That one I preferred. So who knows? Maybe I'm back
in. It's like
in.
2000s, like a bit 2000s, bit we're going to change the world together, brother.
Yeah, a little bit...
Jesus.
Actually, you know what? A little bit reminds me of. So, my lovely girlfriend has been rewatching One Tree Hill on Amazon Prime recently. And I'll tell you what, excellent. And I mean, excellent.
Excrement, you're right.
Excellent soundtrack. Like, you forget how many genuine bangers were on that soundtrack. And there'll be a few episodes where maybe like Dan Scott is like beating someone up or murdering someone. And to save like Nathan or Lucas, and that song came on as he's walking back to the car in the rain or something like that. Yeah, yeah,
yeah. big time.
It's a big, it's a deep cut for the OTA.
It's like 2000 high school.
Yeah.
Yeah. The last one is a girl I discovered through Instagram. Her name is Amelia Moore. And you know that every now and then I'm a bit of a sucker for some vocal gymnastics.
Yes, you love a vocal as delicate as a flower.
Yes, and I'm a bit of a sucker for a good run. You know? Not a run club.
Run club.
Not what happens after a Vindaloo. Just a good vocal run.
Good vocal run.
And this one's called See Through.
Mm.
And I'm just going to play the run because it then sort of drops into a different vibe, which you'll probably hear a little bit of. But let me just play this. See Through, Amelia Moore.
I can't. She's solid.
That was shit. It's true. Red white lies. Won't hide my face from
See through all of my windows, turning you looking at me with an X-ray vision, like skeletons in my closet. Okay,
so it's kind of vibey, but let's get into the news, reviews, and interviews, shall we? That doesn't rhyme very well.
The news wrap.
Shit happening everywhere, Max.
There's a bit on, Sam.
Bit on.
As per. But the biggest piece on, especially today.
Today.
Because like this was going to be material that we missed from a week ago by the time this comes out. But don't worry. There's an update that makes it relevant for us.
There is an update. And we look really timely.
We, boy, do we. Laneway lineup has dropped. It dropped about a week ago at time of listening.
No, it didn't. It dropped today.
That's true. It's, you know, the big headliners are Charlie XCX and Claro.
Yep.
Do you want to run through some of the other names on there? And then we can add in the one who dropped today.
Yes. So there is a secret artist who just was announced. But we've got Biaba Doobie, Bicep, Barry Can't Swim, Remy Wolf, Olivia Dean, Idress Skeggs, Stoom.
I think it might be Stoom, but I don't know.
Yeah, righto. Cultured man. Rona.
She's been on the show.
Have we had Rona on the show?
Yeah.
Yeah, right. Girl and Girl.
Yep.
Julie. That's my mum's name. Fuckers. FC. French Connection UK. Urs.
Yes.
Hamdi. Joey Valance. Hollis. Two Hollis. I don't know how you pronounce that.
Do I have to have seen one Hollis?
I don't know. Hollis Squared.
Good old Nina Durace.
I heard someone say this is a festival for the girls and the gays.
I'm around that. I back
and
that.
And I think it's fairly accurate.
Fuck yeah. Girls, guys, and gays. Let's go.
So it's great to see a festival lineup with predominantly female artists. That's not something that's common. However, like, you know, I don't take much notice of it anyway. But like when you notice it, it's good.
It is nice. And I'll tell you what. I've heard a lot of like rumblings from people on various social media about how much, you know, they do or don't like this lineup. I think this is belters.
Look,
I think a lot of people have been out there being like, and it's fine to not know the lineup. If you don't like it because you don't know it, that's fine. I'm not trying to go.
Yeah,
that's fine.
I think that's what it is. When people don't know the lineup, they go, nah, that's shit.
Yeah.
And look, I'm just going to go out on a whim.
Yeah.
To secure Charlie XCX, Clara and Biaba Doobie alone, you don't have much money to spend elsewhere.
And they've done some pretty incredible stuff. Olivia, we also haven't added who the surprise was as well.
No, we haven't. We'll get to that. But like Olivia Dean.
Yep.
My girlfriend got into her recently. She's great.
So great. Yep. I'm having her new-ish single Time is getting very heavy rotation on my playlist. It's fucking good.
My girlfriend Impulse bought a vinyl for the first time in her life. Whoa. And it was Olivia Dean.
Damn.
And it's been on high rotation. Yep. Remy Wolf's got bangers.
Yep.
Skeggs.
Can't go wrong with skis.
Can't go wrong. The others, I don't really know.
Rona, I think in that kind of uplifting electronic that we've been talking about a lot in the last few weeks.
Yeah.
We had her on the show last year. Maybe. That's a going. I'm flashing back. Maybe it was 2 years ago.
I don't think I was there for that.
Sorry, Rona.
She's not listening.
Fuckers, we had on the universe. On the universe. What the fuck? Fuckers, we had on the show last week, maybe the week before, in something new, the ones that I brought. Joey Valance and Bray, kind of a EDM rap combo that I think people get around. Bicep, everyone knows Bicep. Glue would be the song that I'm sure you would know, even if you don't know it by name.
Maybe.
You know what? Do you want to play some?
No.
Okay.
Actually, even you saying that made me yawn.
And Barry Can't Swim, I didn't really know that well until I went looking for them. So sick. Okay. Little like live dance thing going on.
Well, should we announce the secret headliner?
Who's the secret headliner?
Well, it's not a headliner. The secret artist.
Secret edition.
Jaw.
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 It's Jaw. Jaw, what you doing here?
It is, we've talked about Joe on the show before.
Jaw.
On the Joe yep. on the Joe show. Joe Keery, is that his last name?
I don't know. He was from Stranger Things. Yes. He does End of Beginnings.
End of Beginnings, yeah.
That's the only
song. Loves Chicago.
Yeah, when he's back in Chicago, he feels it, that's for sure.
I've got to say, so I've seen some videos of him live, no good. But having said that, some of his songs that aren't End of Beginnings are bangers. His ones that aren't the TikTok ones,
yeah,
I kind of fuck with.
I showed you the video of End of Beginnings. It was gross.
Yes.
It was poo-poo.
Yeah, no good.
It was caca.
It was wee-wees and cacas.
It was shit.
But.
Just kidding.
Some of his other stuff.
Yeah.
Like the recorded versions.
To be fair, maybe we just saw a bad video.
Might have been a bad day, and that's fine. I think, we'll have those.
Look.
Mine are every Monday.
Yeah, same. Well, and, you know, I think when he plays End of Beginnings, you're not going to really be able to hear him anyway.
That's true.
Because every drunk girl and guy will be like, oh, fucking, when you're back in Chicago, I fucking feel it, mate.
So, all in all, this is pretty sick. We're going to have a little Brat Summer.
You will.
We all will, Sam. Whether you're there seeing Charlie XX live or not, you're having a Brat Summer.
It's a bit skibbity for me.
I hate everything about that.
I don't know what that means.
I hate everything about that.
Skibbity toilet? Is that what they say?
Sure.
Is that what the children say?
Hey, you're asking the person who's older than you.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, you're a little bit more with it than me. I'm in a different world, yeah. Pondy replay. Today. Well,
it's going to be the day.
Yeah, the Knotfest lineup comes out.
Yeah.
But at time of recording, we've got no idea
what this lineup is. This is pre-recorded. So if you're listening to this today, it didn't come out. It's not coming out of our mouths today.
No, it's not. No. Knotfest lineup predictions.
Yeah.
Let's have a crack, shall we?
Fuck, why not? We already know one.
We do. Slipknot are confirmed as the headliner for the 25th anniversary of Knotfest.
Corrence Taylor.
Corrence.
I'm sure that Corey is short for Corrence.
That's a stretch.
Well, Terry is short for Terrence.
True.
So it makes sense, doesn't it?
Yeah. Yeah. Well. Yep. You've thrown me there. All right. So Slipknot.
Larry's short for for Lawrence. So Corey's got to be short for Corrence.
He's cracked himself up.
It's one of the worst fucking dumbest jokes I've ever said, and I don't know why. It's really tickling me. Sorry. Yes. So Corrence Taylor and the boys.
Yep.
In K-Not.
Yep. They're going to be there.
Yep.
So let's have a crack at the rest of the lineup.
Let's have a swing.
We heard a lot of murmurs around System of a Down for Good Things Festival.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Could we see System of a Down at Knotfest?
Well, I mean, they're freshly, oh, not fresh, relatively freshly reformed and touring.
Yep.
So, and Serge, I've seen him everywhere. He seems to be on everything, podcasts, TikTok, everywhere.
Yep.
So they're doing a surge of promotion, which I'm sure is short for surgeons.
Oh, and if he comes back, it's a resurgence.
Thank you.
No worries.
Who's Reese?
Oh, shut up.
But he's urgent.
Oh, you've completely ruined the segment.
Sorry. Yeah, System of a Down, I think, could be... I don't know whether they're a likely or a wishful thinking, but I think we're going to see System of a Down soon in Australia.
Should we say they're a possible?
Possible.
Possible.
Maybe not a probable.
No. Well, why don't you give me a probable?
I don't know if this is probable, but this is another possible. They had a big Olympic, Sam, won gold many times. French metal band Gojira were strapped to the side of a castle, did their thing.
Yep.
They were on the Good Things lineup last year, so that's the 2023 iteration. And
you reckon they'll be back that soon? Well, it's 2025, I guess.
I think, and also they've just had a massive blow up. You know what I mean? Like their profile is through the roof after Paris 2024. So not impossible, I'd say, to see them down here.
I like it.
A possible, maybe not a probable.
Well, I'm gonna go out on a limb and say a probable.
Yeah.
Motionless in White.
Mm-hmm.
Rumors, again, all over them. Good things time.
Yep.
But we didn't see them. So I suspect
we'll
see Motionless in White at Knotfest.
Okay. I like that. A couple of young Aussies who you have been very into recently. A lot, actually. Especially, you know, if you go a couple of episodes back in your feed, I, in fact, did a bit of an album review about these guys.
You did.
Void of Vision. They toured with Parkway, but they didn't make a few of the shows due to some technical problems. So you might think, well, they've got some touring to make up for. Void of Vision. They've been on Knotfest before. I wouldn't be surprised if we see them again. Not necessarily. I'd say that's in between. Approssable, if you will.
Approssable. Well, I feel like the locals are more likely than internationals, you know?
Yeah.
I'm going to keep them on the local train. Make Them Suffer and Ocean Grove. Both will have new albums under their belt.
Yep.
Why not get a festival under there too, you know?
Why not? Ocean Grove, like...
the new metal stuff.
I know that, but I mean, like, there are a band that covers a lot of different sounds.
Mm.
There'd be some stuff that's in the Ocean Grove discography where up against Slipknot where I'd be like, what the fuck is this? But then there's some stuff where I'm like, no, if I, like a lot of stuff of Rhapsody tapes, I'd be like, I can see the connection.
Yeah.
A lot of the stuff of like Flip Phone Fantasy, I'd be like, come again.
Why are you here?
What is this? What kind of dog is this? That's a turtle, sir.
Exactly. The answer one is this. It's cheese.
It's cheese also. Do you know? Because that's like a deleted scene. How few people know that, and how often I say, what is this? Oh, it's cheese also.
I say
like,
what all the
fuck
time.
Are you talking about?
Yeah. I thought it was in the movie. I saw it as a YouTube clip and it's like, dance one.
It's so cheese good. Arsehole. If you haven't seen that, if you go on YouTube, type in Borat cheese, it's probably five of the greatest minutes of anything that didn't make a movie.
And it's 5 minutes you'll just never get back.
That poor dude. He's so polite. He's so kind and patient.
He's the most chill. It's the greatest testament to his character.
Yeah. Yeah. Sacha Baron Cohen is trying so hard to break him and he just doesn't give up.
No. The last one is the instance. It's crackers.
Is it crackers? It said crackers.
Cracker Barrel. It's cheese.
this whole line, this is cheese. What is this?
Then he goes to another one.
Yeah.
But what is this? Butter. Then it cuts.
Sorry.
Last couple.
Yeah.
Anthrax. Mm-hmm. One of the big four.
Big four thrash metal bands.
Yep.
What are the other three?
Well, Megadeth were there last time.
Yes.
Metallica's too big.
Well, Metallica, I still feel like we're going to get a Metallica headline announce sometime soon.
Yeah, but we're not going to get it when Slipknot's already confirmed.
No, yeah, I doubt that. That'd be too big.
I think Anthrax could be there.
Mm-hmm.
And then I feel like we should just have a few Hail Marys in there. Let's just throw some names around, see what sticks.
Well, there's two here that are probables that I feel like we might have skipped.
Yep.
Do you want to go for them?
No, you go.
Go for them. Amon Amarth and Mudvayne have done all the South American legs, Argentina, Brazil, and Chile, with Slipknot.
Chile.
So I'm going to say it's not impossible, maybe probable even, that we get those guys down here. That'd be kind of cool. They were on, I think Amon Amarth were on a Good Things not that long ago. So potentially.
Sorry, a bit tired.
Yeah, big yawn.
I had a big yawn.
I can tell.
Yeah. Glassy eyes.
Yeah.
I'm going to go out on a limb. Hail Mary time.
Go for it.
Gwar.
Gwar. Fuck yeah. I wouldn't mind seeing Gwar live again.
And then I'm going to go out on another limb.
Why not?
And this doesn't have to do... Look, we tossed this up off air. Could we see these two bands? But I'm just going to go out on a limb.
Mm-hmm.
And this is to any...
This is a limb of the limb.
This is a limb of the limb. This is an extension of the extension.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's a dual extension.
Yeah.
This is a call out to any Aussie booking agent.
Yep.
Book a dual headline tour, Nickelback and Creed. I would pay $50 to go and see it.
You know, while we're out here throwing Hail Marys, The Who.
At Knotfest.
Not Pete Townsend, The Who. Like Mongolian, The Who.
Oh, yeah. HU.
Yeah.
Weren't they just here?
They were here, I think, last year.
Mm.
But
who are you?
Mongolian throat singing.
But yeah, I think there's a few in there, a few different options. Shouts to a friend of the show, Mother of Hades, for getting us onto that topic just before we started recording.
Yeah, literally, lifesaver there.
Got us in with minutes to spare.
Yep. Yeah, she did. Well. On that note, let's get into the suitcase. Because
what sound effect are you going for this week?
Zippity doo dah.
I have really had fun when I'm going back and editing all these, saving your little sound effects.
Oh, good.
Yeah. Don't worry about what for. Unrelated.
Fuck. Look, for the suitcase this week, music cliches that shit me.
Yep.
And there's a lot.
Mm-hmm.
But it can be anything from live performances, band photography, things that bands do online, just anything in the musical realm that is cliched or that irks you more than it should.
That ruffles my feathers.
Ruffles your feathers. Rumbles your timbers.
Rumbles my timbers.
Shivers my timbers. Rumbles your...
Grumbles?
Yeah.
Rustles my jimmies.
Yeah, whatever you want to say.
How are you, Jimmy, Sam?
Me jimmies?
Yeah.
I don't know.
Because I'm about to be rustled, Sam.
Okay.
Anyway, would you like to open us up? Because I still need to have a little ponder. So please.
I've been on this for a long time, but I'm just going to put it out there.
Yep.
Again. Encores. Treat people like they're stupid.
Okay.
Hey, guys. We've just finished our 15-song set. We haven't played our two most famous songs, but this is the end. Fuck. We know you're going to come back. Just play it. Keep the energy all in one set. Don't do this weird broken up shit. Nothing shits me more than a very obvious encore.
Look, you have been on this high horse before, and I disagree with you then, and I disagree with you now. It's theater. It's part of the theater. If a band just played their best last song and left and didn't give, it's a 5-minute warning. We're gonna finish soon. We're gonna pretend now. Then we'll come out and we'll do it again. It's like when you got kids and you're like, you can't just turn the TV off and feel like it's done. You're like at the end of the episode, you have to turn the TV off. It's like getting you used to the idea that the show's about to wrap up, that you got to start making your way to the door, think about where you got to be. Because if a band did just absolutely cut it off, you'd all be like, oh, hang on a minute.
But some of the best shows I've been to are where singers get on the stage, third last song, and they go, these are the last two songs. Give it all you've got. This is it. We're not coming back out. Go for it. And then they play their two songs. Everyone goes fucking nuts. And then you end on a high note. There's no like, go hard. Then you go, oh. And then you have to come back up. It's just all up.
Nah, I think the genie's already out of the bottle. If we went back to like the beginning of time and was like, and we were like, okay, this is dinosaurs? How performance, 13.4 billion years ago, there was a big bang, Sam. Pretty big. Yeah. But if we went, if we, at the beginning of like popular performances, went back and said, there's going to be no encores, this is just how it is, I agree with you. But we're already at this point. We can't just start now because people will be like, no, I want a bit more. So you have to give them the warning and make them, even if they know and you know they know and they know you know and all that, you got to go through the steps of like, we're stopping. Oh, a little bit more just for you, a little bonus. And then we're stopping.
Or just do it better.
I don't know. I still think
I know you're coming back out. Don't make me play to your ego and go, one more song. Because I'm not. I'm just going to go, oh, I could beat the traffic here. There we go.
I've got something that's very specific.
That's not like you to be niche.
You know me. It's, and I don't, here's the thing. I don't know how many songs this is in, but I feel like it's in a couple. And I feel like, so I'm going to give this very specific example and broaden it out into a bigger problem. The specific example is rhyming kryptonite, as in Superman kryptonite, with crib tonight. I've heard it in multiple songs, I'm fairly certain. And to me, it's the broader problem is setting yourself up for a rhyme, especially in a hip hop track, where there's really only one way out.
Yep.
And so we can all see it coming, but we just have to wait till the end of the next line or the line after that to get the rhyme.
Mm.
And I'm like,
yeah, obvious rhymes shit you up the wall.
Obvious rhymes. And no, to be fair, like when they subvert them, like if you set up the obvious rhyme, change it up and it like, so there's the implied rhyme.
Mm.
Great. Subvert the genre. But the obvious rhyme where it becomes the obvious rhyme.
Ay, ay, ay.
No bueno.
No bueno. Well, we're tackling different things here. I like it.
Yeah.
I'm going to go into the music video world.
Mm.
Live performance music videos.
Mm-hmm.
Just so boring.
Are you talking live performance music videos where it's an artist has done the performance live, but has then dubbed the recorded version of the song over the top of it.
Yeah.
Okay, I'm with you now.
Boring.
Yeah.
Boring. Boring.
The reverse encore. While they're on. Boring. Leave earlier.
Boring.
The off-core, if you will.
Yeah. Just boring.
Okay.
Do like a high-quality live video. Mm-hmm. I'd watch that. Or I'd watch the music video. Don't combine them.
Yeah.
Like, I don't know. Also, music videos where it's just the band performing in like a warehouse or in the forest. Like, spare me.
Fair. Fair. I back that.
Mm.
This is I don't know if it's something that annoys me or if it's something that where I think that someone thinks they're better than the audience. You know when you go to a show?
Yes.
And a band will be like, especially if it's a touring band, and they're like, we love name of band from your city.
Yes.
Classic in Brisbane is a band comes here and they're like, we love Powderfinger.
Mm.
We all do, mate. We all do. They're the kings of the city. Anyway. And then they're like, to show you how much we love this band, we're going to play a cover. Great. What are you going to hit me with? A bit of bloody Baby I Got You On My Mind, These Days, My Happiness, et cetera, et cetera. No, they go for like a deep cut song off like one of the OG albums. And I'm like, this is great for like the crossover group that is like 45-year-old Powderfinger fans and 25-year-old this band performing fans, where there is like maybe one person in the audience. And usually like, this is me saying this, who's usually that one person in the middle of the two Venn diagrams. So I'm like, if you're going to cover, if you're going to do like a popular cover,
yeah,
do a popular cover and make it yours.
Yeah.
Don't go super deep cut where it may as well just be an original that you wrote because I don't know the cover.
Yeah.
Because that's like, what's the point? Like you're purely showing your like credentials. Like I know the cool song, the cool deep cut from this band. And like, great. It's probably a great song. That's fine. But I'm not coming here to hear you play a song that I don't know,
yeah,
from a band that I maybe know.
It's just a bit arrogant, isn't it?
Either play a song, one of your songs that I may not know, or a song from a band that I do know, where I can be like, cool, this is an interesting take of this song.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, I'm going to go one more on that note.
Go for it.
International bands that do shoeys.
Oh, yeah, and I'm aboard with it. You know what? The shoey in general. It's time that we retire. Australia, it's time we retire the shoey.
I think it's just, A, it's gross. B, it's becoming unoriginal.
Mm.
And C, it's just like, fuck, just let them play.
Let
them play. And then on top of that,
yeah,
bands that come and go, you guys are so much better than Sydney. And you're like, this is my favorite show. And you're like, fuck, shut up. You're saying that to Melbourne, Sydney, Adelaide and Perth. Like, don't treat me like I'm stupid.
You're not saying Adelaide and Perth. I'm going to Adelaide and Perth.
No, they're not.
I say that as someone, just backing up a shoeys for a sec, I say that as someone who's done many shoeys and who has no problem being a grot.
No.
But, like, even if you're a Brisbane Gronko, it doesn't give you, like, don't try and, like, it is gross. Don't force it on someone else. Like, actually forced, if it's, like, just peer pressure, it's pretty gross.
I just think there's nothing I like more than watching artists on stage when the crowd goes like, shoey, shoey, and they go, I'm not doing that, fuck off. And you're like, I just sit there and go, respect.
I mean,
I like that.
They're just like, it's a shoey's gotta be something that you opt in for, not that people encourage you to do.
I feel embarrassed as a member of the crowd when they're chanting shoey at an artist. I'm like, I almost want to go, I'm sorry for that. It's not a reflection of all of us. You do whatever you keep your shoes on. I don't care. Just play the fucking song I paid you to play.
Like Daniel Ricciardo doing it at the end of the F1.
Awesome.
Like he's opting to do that. He has brought this upon himself to be like, I'm going to do a shoey.
Yeah.
Great. Kind of charming. Like it adds like a.
That's the Aussie flair.
Yeah, exactly. Yep. That's like those crazy Aussies. But.
From Melbourne.
Yeah. But if you're out there being like, nah, man, you should do a shoey. Trust me. Drink out of my shoe. It's fucking gross, but you'll love it.
Oh, bro, it's awesome.
Less.
Do a thongy.
Less charming. No. Less charming.
It degrades Australians.
Degrades the shoe, you know?
Yeah.
Respect the shoe.
Yeah. Most Australians have done shoeys.
I wouldn't say most.
I'd say a good 50% of the population has done a shoey.
Of the entire population.
Of the entire population.
You know what? Statistically, I reckon that should be a question on the census.
Dad, if you're listening, you're doing it at Christmas. 51%. There's 100 people in Australia. But anyway,
yeah,
that wraps up the suitcase.
Yeah,
back to the suitcase.
We've taken it to the
packed
airport.
The suitcase up,
put it in that plastic wrap,
and then we left it just randomly in a near a seat.
Yeah,
and then we've walked away.
Bags without people, Sam. They do make sense.
Yeah, and then the airport's been locked down, but we're on the taxi on the way to the valley anyway, so it doesn't matter.
Yeah. I left my boogie board in Bali.
Yeah, I did. But, you know, you get that on the big jobs.
Point to you.
But, you know, thank you everyone for coming. We love you all. Hopefully we gave you some new songs that you like.
It's been pleasurable.
It's been certainly an experience, and we'll see the three of you next week.